14-day... I don't even know anymore. Anyway, so welcome to my channel. This is probably the first time you heard my voice in my videos, so I hope you're not disappointed too much. But you know, it's been really boring here. We're not able to go anywhere to do anything fun, so I figured, you know what? I do my makeup every day for literally no reason. So I'm like, no, let me just do a chit chat, get ready with me, and I hope you enjoy. So I already did my eyebrows because they take me usually like around 20 to 30 minutes, and I did not want to bore you with that. And I also already primed my face using the e.l.f. Primer. And yeah, that's that. So I'm not gonna do anything crazy with my eyes, I don't think so, cause right now I really don't feel like doing crazy eye looks. I'm usually more focused on my face and looking very natural, but no glam. So alright, let's see how it's gonna turn out. Into my eyes first. And I'm using the Too Faced Born This Way concealer in the color Snow. This is like one of my favorite concealer for everything, and surprisingly this is the only color of concealer or foundation that I've ever found that actually matches me 100%. So if I want to use it for like highlight, I usually mix it with this ColourPop concealer in white. I think that's the name. No, the name is Fair 00, and I'll lighten it up. But yeah, so I'm just gonna put a little bit on my eyelids to prime it, because I don't really use eye primers. I think it's just like a marketing thing, you know, like an eye primer. That's my opinion. And my two favorite brushes to blend concealer and foundation now are these two from BoxyCharm. The smaller one I use for the concealer. I like. Alright, so now let's just use the small one and blend the concealer, my eyes. And I will set it immediately with powder, because I have very hooded eyes and very oily eyelids too. So if I don't do that, then they're gonna crease, and we don't want that. I'm not gonna tell you what powder I used, because I did this thing where I mixed all of my powders in one, and at this point I don't remember how many powders I mixed. Sorry. I like the idea of mixing your powders. I don't know, like, if it does anything different than just having like one powder. I don't know, it works for me. Alright, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use like a natural, like a neutral color on my crease. Nothing really too much. I'm gonna use this Luxie 103 Mini, and I use this contour palette that I have, and I'm gonna use the two lightest colors, and I'm just gonna use that to put in my crease. Nothing really too much, just for some definition, because again, when you have hooded eyes and you put like eyeliner on, sometimes I don't know how to explain it, but like it makes you look like you have like no lid space, and it's the weirdest and most annoying thing ever. So I'm trying to create a fake lid so it looks like more natural. It's actually impossible. Alright, so just a little bit here, a little bit there. I'm not even sure if you can actually see it in camera, but in real life you can see it, and it does. Alrighty, and then I usually like to bring my eyeshadows upwards because I like the lifting effect, but you can do whatever feels better for you. That's that, and then I'm gonna use like a fluffy brush, like a clean fluffy brush, and then just blend it a little bit so it's not that harsh. And that's about it. So I'm gonna do other eye as well, and then they closed the parks, and then we had like nowhere to go, and I was like stuck home doing nothing. And I live in the basement, which is even worse because there's no sun coming in, no sun whatsoever. I had like a tiny little window in the kitchen, so I would be stuck home with no sunshine, seeing no people, doing absolutely nothing. So yeah, that had been really harsh. And like, I know they opened the parks again now, but it still is a little weird, you know, because it's been like so long. And like, I'm trying like to be more positive now, and, you know, just keep a sane mind, but it's hard. Like, anyway, so let's just try to be positive about it. Hopefully it's gonna be over soon, so fingers crossed for that. Alright, so for my wing, I'm gonna use my new favorite eyeliner. You guys have to check it out. I promise you're gonna love it. It's the Physician's Formula eyeliner. Sorry about this, guys. My camera just died. I don't know why. So we're switching to the iPhone 8. Hopefully this is good enough still. So I just finished my wing. Hopefully you saw a bit of it. So I don't know what to say. This eyeliner is the best I've tried. I've tried so many high ends. Like, have the Huda Beauty here. This is like a NYX eyeliner, which is like honestly trash. Sorry about that. Sorry, not sorry. But this is like amazing. Let me do the other side and speed it up and see how easy it is. And sorry if I keep my mirror too close to my face sometimes and I don't realize it. I have really, really terrible eyesight. So sometimes I really need that extra help, so I'm sorry about that. Alright, so for now, this is going to be the eyes. And I'm going to finish them up later. Alright, so for now, let's just move to the face. And as I said, I already primed. So I'm just going to go straight with my foundation. Which, usually I mix my foundations because lately I've been more into like the... Not that full coverage, but I also want my face to be, you know, one seamless color. So I've been using the, what is that, ColourPop Perfect, ColourPop Pretty Fresh Hyaluronic Acid Tinted Moisturizer. And I'm not sure if these have colors. Oh yeah, there we go. Fair 2W. And I've been mixing this because this is a tinted moisturizer, so it doesn't have a lot of coverage. So I usually just mix this with a little bit of my Too Faced Born This Way concealer, and I get A, perfect color, and B, a really good coverage. And I usually have to mix this because I don't know exactly what it's in here. I think it's like different kind of oils. And when you actually like pour it in your hand, it's like, it almost looks, actually today's much better. But it kind of looks like you can actually like settle, if you know what I mean. Alright, and I just put one pump of my concealer. It looks like that. And then I usually just get the end of a makeup brush, like something like small and tiny, and I just mix them together. Anyway, so what else? I don't know, life has been pretty crazy lately. I'm one of the few lucky people that actually still have a job. I work in a chiropractic office. I'm like, there was an administrator, and she still is open and working. Not the same, you know, we don't really have like all the patients that we used to have, but you know, at least I still work and make some money. I used to be working for like 20 plus hours, and I'm down to 10, which honestly is not ideal, but you know what, it's all right. At least like I have a job, at least I make some money. Yeah, that's okay at this moment. I'm not sure if it looks a little light, but I'm gonna fix it later with bronzer and all that. But like, look at the coverage still, look at the difference. I mean, it still looks like skin, but it looks like a better version of your skin. You know? And I don't know. It really is really weird, the situation that we're in right now. Like, I love going out, I love going to the mall, I love going shopping, I love being outside in the sun, especially now that the weather's getting better. Well, kind of. We had like a snowstorm yesterday. We're not gonna talk about that. But like, it makes me happy being out with people and I, you know, doing my own thing. And this quarantine has really ruined a lot of all that. And I had like so many plans. Like I was gonna go to Miami for my graduation, which also I also lost my graduation because of Miss Corona. So that's something I've been really sad about. But yeah, I was gonna go to Miami. Then in the summertime, we had plans for my friends to go to Boston for a couple of days. That's also canceled. It's just, you know, a lot of things I had planned for like my final year, like my graduation and everything, just are not gonna happen. And it's just really sad, you know, because when you work towards something for like so long and you really want it to happen and then it doesn't happen, it's kind of fucked up. But you know, what can you do? At least I'm healthy, you know. Because I'm healthy, I'm still working, and hopefully this is going to be over soon. And then we can talk about it in a couple of years, and I'm going to laugh about it. Hopefully. Yeah, so what's going on with you? Like, did you guys miss anything? Did you like the situation? Do you don't like it? There are specific aspects of this that I'm okay with. Like, the fact that people have learned, like, to go out more and enjoy, like, a nice walk around the neighborhood and everything, which is really nice. But I don't know. If I had to choose, I would just say no. I want this to be over. What else has happened? Yeah, I've been talking with a lot of my friends and family from Greece. If you guys do not know, I'm Greek. I live in the US now because I'm a student here, but I'm originally from Greece. And they handled the whole situation way better than they did here in the United States. So they're not even as bad as us. Like, they might have like maybe 10 cases a day. And now they actually opened everything up again. And people are going to the beach, they're having fun, they're going, you know, shopping and everything, and we're here doing nothing. What do you guys think? All right, now for the concealer. Like I said before, I'm gonna apply these to cover all my dark circles and everything. And then I'm gonna put some of the lightest concealer on top so I can also highlight. I have a round face, so I really try to keep everything in the center and not give a lot of light to the sides, because that would make my face look just even bigger than it is and rounder. So if you have like a more like round shape, this is a good trick. Just keep all the light in the center and try to elongate your face. Trust me, that would make a huge difference. A little bit here, a little bit there, and that's pretty much good. And take the small brush again, blend, 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 blend. Like, there was a period where I used to be like crazy about making crazy eye looks, like with different colors, different shapes, cut creases. I mean, I still do that because I do love it. I love the creativity that makeup gives you. But I don't know, lately I've been like so bored. I haven't really had a mood to do anything. So I'm focusing more on my skin. So I want to be able to have I want to be able to have my skin looking as good as possible. And let's be honest, nobody is born with great skin. And if you do, then God bless. I'm jealous, but I wasn't that lucky, so I like to pretend to have amazing skin with makeup. Okay, that's that. By the way, the white concealer from ColourPop, it really doesn't give a lot of coverage, which, I don't know. If you use it as a concealer, then you probably hate it, but if you use it the same way I do, just for highlighting, then that's perfectly fine with me, because I don't want to have a cakey face either. So having two full coverage concealers on your under eyes, that's a bad thing. That's a no, don't do that. Alright, so I'm going to try and leave this sit on my face for a little bit, and I'm going to use a brow gel. The one that I have right now is from Maybelline, it's called Brow Drama. And I mean, it's alright. I'm kind of confused about the wand. It's like a very weird shape. I've never seen anybody have the same wand. But I bought two of these that were on sale, so I want to just be over with these until I get like a new one. And I mean, it does the job. It keeps the hair up. I'm not complaining about that. It's just that I have to be very careful. Sorry, itchy nose. I have to be very careful because of the way this is shaped. So if I just, you know, just go in there, probably gonna put all the brow gel around my brows. And we don't want that. I usually only go with one coat. And after I'm done, you know, with my powders and my eyes and everything, I might go with a second coat. Because sometimes, you know, particles from the powder or the eyeshadow or the highlight might go on the eyebrows. So I like to do that in order to clean them up and make sure the hair stay up a little longer. It's a weird thing, all my hair on my face, like my eyelashes and my eyebrows, they have a tendency to go down, like none of them stay up. It's so flipping annoying. Like, I'm gonna put the brow gel on my eyebrows and the mice stay up like temporarily, and then a couple of hours go by and they're still like so annoying. So if you guys have any good suggestions for like a really strong eyebrow gel, let me know, because I could really use one. All right, and now I'm gonna go with my powder again. All right, and I use like a more dense brush for like areas like under my eye, my chin, and my middle of the forehead. And when I go for the rest of the face, I will go with a more fluffy brush, something like that. All right, only because like on areas like that, like the under eyes, I really need more powder, because I am combination to more to oily skin. So a couple hours in, my skin starts like to produce oils, and especially under my eyes and around my nose and everything, my foundation tends to separate. So I'm trying to make sure that it's nicely covered with powder. Not too much, you don't want to look like very cakey. But you know, just the correct amount that you think that your face can handle. At least that's my opinion. I might be wrong, I don't know. That works for me. Alright. And the chin. Has any of you made a list of the things you want to do after you're done with quarantine? I haven't, because I'm not really a list person, but I have so many ideas of what I want to do. The first thing, it might sound a little shallow, but the first thing I want to do is I want to go to the mall. Because I love going to the mall. There's so many stores, you can go shopping, you can go and eat something, you can go and get a drink. So many people around, like, oh my god, I never believed that day would come that I would say I want to see people. Always at first, I guess. I want to go to the beach, oh my god, so bad. I don't even think that there's a possibility that the beaches are going to be closed for the summer. Please god no, because come on, let's keep it real, like there's no summer if you cannot go to the beach, like honestly.
Okay, fluffy brush. What else I want to do?
I want to go out with my friends as much as I possibly can. I want to go out clubbing, I want to go out and get like drinks, go to the boardwalk. And this is my first summer where, like, when I'm done with school and have nothing to worry about. So I really want to enjoy it as much as I can. So I really hope things open up again, please. Okay. Sometimes I would just feel my face and see if I missed any spot and where it feels like moist, I guess, again, or like wet. I can't believe I said and just go over it again. Like I stipple on it and then I like swirl. It makes any sense, because I want stippling it in my head, like puts a lot of product in, and then when you swirl it, you take all the excess product out. So I think that's the best thing that I do. Right, and after I'm done with my powder, I'm gonna take my setting spray. And right now the only ones that I have are like illuminating ones, which I don't know. I mostly like the illuminating ones for summertime, but you know, why not? My favorite so far has been the Iconic London. Probably you can see that. But yeah, I'm gonna use this one just a little bit, just so I can melt, can help the powder melt in my face. Sometimes I wouldn't even pat it in, because I don't like when sometimes I see like specific parts where there's like more of the spray. Alright, now let's continue with the face. Do I want to contour or no? I will contour. Palette I've been using lately has been the Too Faced Cocoa Powder. And to be fair, this is not really my favorite. The powders here are really sheer. Like, watch this. I'm gonna put my finger here. Can you even see anything? Can you even see anything? Like, you really have to dig in to see something. And then, even like that, you still do not see anything. Like, I don't know. And this was really expensive too. I think it was like, I don't know, like $40-$50. For that amount of money, I would expect way more. But you know, at least if you, I think this is good if you're a beginner. Like, it helps you so you don't like overdo it, so you don't like put too much product and then you're like, oh shoot. But for me, I don't know, I find it really annoying. Plus, I find the colors being a little more warm. And if you know anything about contour, you know it has to be like as a shadow. So it has to be most like ashy gray even shade. Certainly nothing warm, because that's like the bronzer's job. And these are just very warm. So, not a fan of this. So if you want to buy a contour palette, I would just tell you, do not invest your money in this. Try the Kat Von D Shade and Light, which honestly, I should have bought that one instead. But, you know, I don't know what I was thinking, honestly. I think the packaging really got me, because I like a good packaging. And Too Faced really does a great job when it comes to packaging. Even though the products are not the best. Sorry, not sorry. But yeah, I won't do that mistake again. Cut to me like 20 minutes later, and I'm like, oh my god, look what I got. And I usually do my chin as well, because as I said before, I have a round face, so I'm trying to eliminate some of my jaw and give the illusion of like more of a heart-shaped face. Not even an oval shape, because personally I find heart-shaped faces much more attractive, but that's like my personal opinion. Go like this. And then for my nose, I have a specific brush that I've been using. I think it's the same one I used for my crease. This brush has made my contour so easy. Like, it's like so easy, I don't even have to try. So I just draw two straight lines coming from my eyebrow. And if you connect your nose contour to your eyebrow, it just makes it more natural. And then when I come to my tip, I just go a little around. Make like a nice round little nose. And my nose already has the shape that I'm trying to replicate. The only thing I do is like I'm trying to make it a little smaller. I don't know why, I don't know. I think the small noses are cute. So I'm going around the tip, and then sometimes I will draw like a line on the top to give it over like a lifted effect. A lifted effect. Damn, that was a tongue twister. And just make sure it's like visible. I don't want it to be too, you know, light to the point where it doesn't even make a sense, but not even too harsh. So I will go over it, and then I take the same brush I used my powder and mix the two highlighting powders. Just go around it and make the lines a little less harsh and over it, and voila. So that's for the contour. Then for bronzer, right now I have this Stila bronzer in the shade Light, and this is my favorite right now, and you probably can tell. And for the brush, I'm gonna use this unicorn angle brush. I'm not sure if you can tell, it has a little bit of an angle, but it does. And this bronzer is not too pigmented, but it's not like not pigmented, so it helps you start light and then build it up to heavier and heavier if that's what you want. And usually how I do it is I start from the back closer to the hair, and then what is left in the on the brush I bring it closer. I like a nice sun-kissed look, especially now. So what are your plans for summertime? Like,
you guys actually think we're gonna be able to travel again, you know, live a normal summer, or nah? I'm trying to be positive, I'm staying positive. I want to believe that, you know, it's gonna be a decent summer. Maybe not the best, or what we have planned, but maybe like a decent summer, you know? Alright. And that's that. Now, I used to hate putting blush on, but I've grown to like it a little more. Still not crazy about it, but you know, something. So I'm gonna put a little bit of this T London in Marbled Light Burned. And this has a little bit of a highlight on, which I like. And I'm gonna use this Moda brush. All right, and so I'm gonna get a little bit of this. Make sure to dust all the excess because I really do not like too much blush. And smile. And put just a little bit on the apples on my cheeks. And I do make sure to blend it up because, again, I don't like blush. Maybe a little bit on my nose. A little bit on the temples. And that's it. You probably can't really see a big difference, but in person you can tell. And I like that. Alright. Now for a highlight, that's always the deal with me because I have a bunch of highlights that I really like. And I can never really choose what I want to use. Alright, so for the highlight, today I'm going to use the Kylie Cosmetics highlight in Banana Split. This is the one that I like to use when it's a nice sunny day because it has like a nice yellow color. And when the sun hits you, it looks like you have like a golden hour glow, which I really love. So I'm going to spray my brush a little bit. And I'm also going to spray my sides. I find the highlight looks better on a more like wet surface. So I'm gonna dig right in. And top of the cheekbones. Oh, this is such a nice color. And I usually go a little heavy on highlight because I love highlight. So you don't have to go as heavy as me. You can just, you know, do your own thing. But I like a lot of highlights, so I'm gonna put a lot of highlight. Put a little bit on my tip of my nose, bridge of my nose, a little bit in between my eyebrows, arch of the eyebrow, chin, cupid's bow, lips. Told you I really go heavy with this thing. Underneath the eyebrows for a nice lifting effect, and that's it. Use this, what is this? Luxie 141 little brush. And I'm gonna take a little bit of my bronzer and I'm gonna put it on the lower lash line. I have droopy eyes, so I have to be careful of how I place the shadow because it can bring my eyes down even more and make them even more droopy. We don't want that. So I'm gonna show you the trick I do to make my eyes appear less droopy. So I'm gonna put a little bit of these under my eyes. It's not too much, just, you know, something. There we go. And the other side. So what have been your favorite YouTubers to watch for quarantine? I've been like switching to like the same few people. I've been watching a lot of Shane Dawson, like, you know, the OG videos, conspiracy theories, mostly because they're long, so I can just put them in the background while I do anything I want. Been watching a lot of like Nikki and Gabby, like Gabby DiMartino and Nikki. Also, I've been watching a lot of ASMR, like a lot of ASMR. Trying to keep, you know, my mental health kind of stable, if it's even possible. What else? I think that's pretty much it. Like the same few people, honestly. let's go to the eyelashes. So a trick you can do to help your eyelashes stay up a little longer is to breathe. You can either breathe on it so it warms up, or you can use a hair dryer to do that, but I would not recommend that because it can actually burn your eyes if it's too hot. So this is what I do. And I keep it in for a couple of seconds, just wiggle it. Whatever feels right for you, honestly. But like my eyelashes are really straight, so I keep it on for as long as I possibly can. You can see a difference. And then the other eye. Same thing, just wiggle around. Keep it there for as long as possible. And now, I have a bunch of mascaras that I use, but right now I've been into the CoverGirl Peacock Player. And it's funny because when I first bought this, I thought it was so like cheap because the wand looks very like plasticky, but it does a great job. Like, I don't know what about it, it's so good, but it really keeps your eyelashes long and full, and you know, when it comes from me, like there's not many mascaras that do things for my tiny little eyelashes. So when I see that, I see a difference, that means it's a good mascara. And it's cheap. I think it was like around less than $10 for sure. I don't remember right now, but I would definitely check it out. Especially if you're in a budget. Okay, what else now? I don't know, man. Like, life has been so boring lately. Like, sometimes I would call my friends from Greece and FaceTime. And we don't even have things to say. Like, it's sad. I've been trying to keep myself occupied. So, like, I've been trying to exercise, not really. Maybe, like, going to the park for walks, watching a bunch of YouTube, watching a bunch of shows on Netflix. Try to clean the house, like, oh my god, I cleaned my apartment, can you believe that? And I tried, shoot. Of course that would happen to me, anyway, I'll fix it later. Now just trying to keep myself occupied as much as I can, so I don't lose my fucking mind. And I don't even know if it's working, so. Alright, so I'm gonna use the same highlighter I used before and just put a little bit on my inner corner, and by a little bit I mean a lot bit. There and there. Alright. Now so the trick I was gonna tell you about droopy eyes. So what happens is that droopy eyes basically means that the lower part of your eye is mostly going downwards, creating this sad effect. So what I do is I use a shadow, and by shadow I mean something dark, only on the outer part of the lower part of my eyes, because that kind of cancels the motion going downwards, and it tricks the eye thinking that, oh no, this is not going downwards, there's a shadow, there's like a liner there, so the eye is like more symmetric. I'm not really good at explaining this, but I think you can get the point when I'm actually gonna show you. So I take a black eyeliner. This is the Huda Beauty one, and it's a really good one. And I apply the liner only on the outer lower part of my eyes, halfway in. So now look at the difference. Look at this eye, and look at this eye. You can tell like your eye is tricked into thinking that no, this is a more symmetrical eye. Where in this one, you can tell the eye is going a little more downwards. Oh, let me do the same thing to this eye. By the way, this is a very nice black eyeliner, and it lasts a long, long time. So, it's like $20, and it's like, it has both sides. So, honestly, I would recommend this. Alright, and if I'm in the mood, I'm also gonna tight line, and you don't have to. I just do it because I feel it makes the eyelashes look fuller. And it also helps
so I just did them quickly off camera, and I used, I used this AOA black glue for the eyelashes, and it's like $1.88 if you go to shopmissa.com. This is my absolute favorite glue, and it's the cheapest one you can find out there. And the way I place my eyelashes is I have a new technique now. So instead of just putting the glue on the eyelash and then put the eyelashes on your eyes, I put the glue directly on my eye as an eyeliner, let it dry, and then I place the eyelash on. Doing it that way, it's easier for beginners especially, because sometimes you even I struggle with, like, especially with my inner corners and the outer corners. But when you place the glue directly on your eye, you already know where your eyelash is gonna go, and it makes it way, way easier. So I place them on, and then I push them up a little bit. That helps them know the which way you want them to go, because sometimes I can put the eyelashes on and they tend to go down and look straight. So by doing this, you help them stay up. Alright. And I think that's about it for the face. Now, what I've been doing for my lips lately, because I've been more into the natural and the summer glow, but the way my lips the outline is not very defined. So if I put a gloss on, you can't even see the actual shape of my lips, which are, in my opinion, they're pretty big and full. So what I do is I try to define them, but only on the cupid's bow, the bottom middle of the lower part of the lower lip. English. So the one lip liner that I've been using is from Morphe, and it's called Makeup Talk. It's a very nice neutral color for the lips, which I love. Unfortunately, mine is not sharpened right now, and I do not know where my sharpener is, so bear with me. So I'll go like this. Only up to the middle of the upper part of the lip. And then on the lower. And then I take my ring finger and I try to blend it. Top and bottom. Not too harsh, be as gentle as possible. Make sure there's no harsh lines so it can look nice and natural. And I take one of my lip glosses, and right now the one that I've been using the most is the Wet n Wild Color Icon lip gloss in Pisces. Guess why? Shout out to my fellow Pisces out there, because this lip gloss, it's so us. It's just magic in a little bottle. Honestly, he love unicorn, unicorn skin, galaxy, pink, glitter. This is gonna be your new jam. So if you can get your hands on this Pisces lip gloss, do it. I like my lips being nice and full when I wear lip gloss, so it might be a little extra. Or you can do as much as you feel like. Can't wait to wear all this new makeup out and have the sun hit it and be in the- Imagine being on the beach, laying down with this nice lip gloss on and this nice highlight. Oh, come on. Goals. Do a final spurt of my setting spray. And this makeup is done. But I have a little extra in this video because I'm bored. And I actually received my new outfit yesterday in the mail. So I'm gonna put my hair down, put my new outfit on, and I'm gonna come back and show you the full thing.
telling you about. And the boots. Pretty simple, really nice, very comfortable. Okay everybody, so this was the full video. I hope you enjoyed it and thank you for hanging out with me. If you want more videos like this, and you can just subscribe to my channel and hit the little notification bell so you can be a part of the family. And thank you all very much, and love you. Be safe and have a good day.